Logan, everybody, and welcome to the Sports Challenge. I'm glad you're with me this weekend. You know, there's no doubt about it, winter's definitely here. We had our first big snowfall of the season, and you know there's more to come. So, as kind of a community service project, I wanted to bring to you some of our warm weather, summertime sports challenges. So please, sit back, relax, and enjoy the fun that we have in the summertime. Because God knows we got enough winter to last us for a lifetime. But don't worry, I still made Harry come out here on the deck and talk Bear football. We'll be back in about 15 minutes, but until then, enjoy. Hi, buddy.
Hey, senor, get the whistle.
Time out.
We tied once again.
Yeah, we tied once again.
We're going to start picking either opposite
games. Hey, here's my sister. You didn't know I had a sister. Here's my sister.
This is not the same one you brought before.
Judy, this is Judy, my sister.
Hi, Judy.
Give him a kiss and we tied again, folks. We tied. Isn't he lovely? Isn't he lovely?
This is
you're so sorry.
Isn't he wonderful? What do you think? What? You like my family?
I love your family.
Look at that. Look at that, folks. I can't believe this.
The next time we tie, I get to bring out one of my sisters.
You got it. You got. Well, I know all your sisters.
Can we?
Good.
I know all your sisters.
Here, can I pull a video trick?
Ooh,
yeah.
Gorgeous.
Okay, let's all wave to the camera. Wave. Bye. Oh, Harry. That was fun.
Yeah, I tell you what, isn't that lovely? Sisters are always ones to love.
You're watching Bill Wyatt's Sports Talk Show, and Steve McMichael, it's one of his favorite. Right, Steve?
What's that?
Bill Wyatt's Sports Talk Show. It's one of your favorites, right?
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
There you go.
Here we are, folks. The Ultimate Sports Dome. The Randall Liquors challenging team. Randall Liquors, Cassie Hollerbush against Team Wyatt, Harry the Heck.
Ready? Go!
And they're off, there's the start. Cassie Hollerbush jumping way ahead, folks. Jumping way ahead for the lead.
Harry tried to run me over?
Oh, definitely, Billy. You better watch out too on the corners there.
Hey, Rick?
I think I gotta say, Harry kind of jumped out there for a while, tried to run over Billy.
She's looking strong.
You obviously chose the right partner for this event.
She's looking strong right now.
Let's go, Harry!
Cassie making a charge for it, pulling away. Folks, we got 5 laps today with one driver. Then the changeover is at 5 laps. Total of 10 laps, and there goes Cassie, about 95 around that turn. Also, we're going to have an interview later with Christy Konomacki in the pits with the drivers after they get off the rough 5-lap stretch.
Let me just add that, of course, Randall Liquors is open at 10 a.m. in Montgomery.
10 o'clock, right before the Bears game.
Rick made it out to the race car. Oh, here comes Harry down the straightaway.
Back to the races. We could have a lap here, folks. Harry Childress working the kinks out there in the backstretch. Cassie just going after it. It's nice to see youth out there with such a big smile.
Oh, she's just blowing them away right now. She's just blowing them away.
Would you say it's because of your pit crew or is it just the machine out there?
It looks like the driver myself. I think it's the driver.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. She's a good driver, but I've never seen Harry drive so slow, Billy.
I don't know what got into Childress.
It could be a malfunction. Take some tires off. Harry wants to cut through, folks. He's trying to cut through.
Cassie comes by and she goes, Randall Liquors!
Oh, Harry, he's really sucking wind here, folks.
Take some tires off.
Oh, and here we are.
She got shot a lap in him?
The Grand Prix of Aurora.
She's going to lap him.
Here comes Cassie. She's almost got a full half lap.
Mike, our strategy comes into play as soon as Harry pulls into the pits and I get behind the wheel. Okay, here comes Rick. Here comes the ever-important exchange. Let's see if I can slow it up a little.
Oh, Billy, trying to make it as close as possible, folks. Oh, nice try, Billy. Nice try. Oh, it's burning rubber. Cassie Hollerbush. Oh, man. Where did you get your racing experience? Oh, there's Harry. Harry wants to make. Harry's trying to make a running. Harry, this is not a track race. It's not like tossing a baton out, Harry. Unbelievable. Oh, Billy. Billy Saddlebrock. Oh, Harry's getting some tips. Yeah, this is how to win. Oh, there goes Harry. He's going to move some tires, folks. Cassie, you did a great job out there.
It's determination out there. Randall's got to go all the way. That's all there's to it.
Well, how did you? What do you attribute to that large lead you got? Ouch, the mosquitoes are biting out there. What do you attribute to that large lead?
I'm not sure. I figured it was going to be a little tough against them, but then as I got ahead of them, I knew it was going to be easy all the way.
Well, folks, this is just something that proves that women drivers, you know, all those jokes about them, it's not true.
Well, actually, you know, behind here I can do anything I want. They say I'm dangerous on the road, so it just proved point today that I am.
Thanks a lot, Cassie. Getting back to the heated action here. Oh, Bill Wyatt, trying to, Harry Childers, he's maneuvered there. He's trying to move some tires, and I think he almost had a coronary, folks. Harry, he's a strong guy, but, I mean, there's probably about 500 pounds of rubber out there. Team Hollerbush, just rubbing it in right now. Unbelievable, folks. Could be. Could definitely be Master Cylinder. Oh, we got a confrontation out here. Oh, Rick trying to make it a good contest. And here we go. Oh, that does not have reverse. We got a wipe out on the third turn. Wipe on the hairpin turn. Oh, need some help. It's up for grabs now, folks. It's up for grabs. So actually, Hollerbush is only an eighth of a lap ahead of Wyatt now. Billy hitting the tires in the back turn. Here's the last lap. This is it, folks. This is the final lap. Here comes Wyatt on the charging on the final turn. Hollerbush has got the lead, though. He's playing like Mario Andretti, just teasing him to come by. I think Hollerbush has got the horsepower, folks. What's that, Harry?
They have no pickup.
Well, we.
I think it had to do with my weight.
I think we saw him put some sugar in the gas tank, Harry.
I was so heavy that I think that that held.
Oh, here he comes, the final lap here. Oh, Rick Hollerbush staying up. Billy Wyatt holding up. Oh, here it comes down to the finish, folks. They're the one all I can get. It's going to be Team Hollerbush with the victory. Oh, another great sports challenge. Oh, folks.
I just want to point out that his arms are attached to his body. This is not a fake person.
Good afternoon, everybody. Mike Leonardi here from Sesquicentennial Park in front of the Paramount Art Center.
Robert, fasten him in. We want to.
Dan Morlock, magician extraordinaire with Bill Wyatt right now.
And these are stainless steel, nickel-plated, ratchet teeth buckles. The tighter you pull, the tighter they get.
Billy's been practicing at the Elgin Nut House this whole week, so he should be ready for this. He's been practicing, though. Even got a couple Houdini books from the library, I heard.
This should have been done long ago.
Very well put. The crowd is agreeing with that. This could be one of the shortest-lived sports challenge ever.
One last strap, and we usually let our assistant Tricia take care of these straps. This shouldn't hurt, though.
Oh, jeez. Oh, thank God Billy's got a kid already. Little Gabby, of course, for you Sports Challenge fans. Yes, Billy is taking a dip. He's married and has a beautiful baby girl. Fanny and Gabby in the audience.
All set, Bill? All right, my turn.
Oh, this is going to be great. I wonder if Billy's ever... the possibility... Could never get out of this.
At the same time.
They may leave him in this.
And kids, again, don't go home and try this. Only Bill and I can do this. Leave the straitjacket in the closet, kids.
Nice to your package. Ouch. Oh, what do we got? Oh, wiping the brow. Billy, take over from Dan. I'd follow Dan and do as much as I could here.
All right, I need everybody to count from five down to one. And then you're going to say go, and they're going to try to get out of there. Nope, no watch. Who's got a watch with the second hand?
Billy, follow Dan's every move, bud. If you know what's good for you, follow his moves. not a good feeling, Leo.
Is everybody ready?
It's not a good feeling. Follow his every move, Billy.
With me now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
When Dan's doing this out in the open, I thought he'd probably go inside to do this. Struggling as they may.
15 seconds.
Billy's getting there. He better practice for this, because this could be a prerequisite for going in the rubber room someday down the Aurora Police Station. So, thank God he hasn't made it there yet. Dan, there goes Dan.
30 seconds.
Over the arm, Billy. That's what you got to do, over the arm. This is something, folks, that you've got to be very, very limber to do. I think Dan's just teasing the audience too here. I bet you he can get out of it. There he goes. He's tipping, ducking the head. Watch Dan, Billy. Just copy Dan, Billy. Billy, get your head tucked underneath your arm there. Come on, Billy. Get that head underneath the arm, Billy.
1 minute.
Oh, man. Billy was barking up the wrong tree. And it's... Okay.
Minute done.
Super Brother music. Oh, Dan's out. Dan's out, and he's working on the buckles now. Get the head underneath, Billy. Head underneath. Come on, Billy. Get the head underneath there now.
1:30.
Dan Morlock, what a great magician he is. He's been doing this for, I believe it's about 15 to 20 years now. He started when he was a kid.
40,
oh, very good. Very good, Dan.
The question is, do we let Bill out?
No, no, don't. Martin Falcone looking for his favorite spot. He's here, it comes.
Bueno.
Oh, off the iron.
Tone for these spectacular layups.
Oh, another spectacular layup, Billy says.
Ole!
Ole! Hebra, hebra! Nice one, Billy.
Martin? Right in.
Layup. Whoa!
Bueno, ole.
Over the rim!
Woo!
Over the rim! Elevation! Woo!
This is to symbolize how Martin will bend over backwards for you at Pique Taco.
Thank you. Ole!
Oh, that's not like the way he will, but close.
Se equivocó.
Yeah, there is a strong wind blowing this way.
Too much wind.
Okay, Martin, your court. I got your PI.
Oh, from the white line.
Muy bueno.
From the white line, Bill Wyatt will be shooting.
Go, go, go.
Oh,
Guillermo.
Alesto. Oh, dejected Bill Wyatt.
Oh, we need to take a shot. Martin.
Bueno.
Whoa, reverse ole, layup. Bueno. Reverse Pol- layup.
Exacto.
Oh, Martin Jr. Excelente.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, beautiful. Oh, Wyatt.
Oh.
Oh, out of control, oh. Billy Wyatt. He is just going past the sound barrier.
Look
at Martin. He's like, hey.
PI. Leo, don't make me edit.
Anyway, here we go. Martin. Backwards. Oh!
Muy bueno.
Martin.
Eso es pique taco.
Pique taco shot, sí. Unbelievable.
Is that the pique
especial? Era la firma de pique taco.
Pique especial.
Woo!
I will put $100 on the shot.
Oh.
Oh, darn it. PIQ to PI.
Those trick shots are tough.
Round, round,
us.
Oh, he loses. Billy Wyatt loses. PIQUE to PIQU.
Adios.
Adios.
Oh, Billy's leaving town. That's such a bad showing. He will be serving tacos down at Pique Taco. Come on down. The greatest service you've ever seen in your life.
Well, the competition of all... Well, the competition is over.
Hi, I'm Dave Wannestadt. You're watching Bill Wyatt's Sports Challenge.
full-service financial planning and investment firm, Stifel Nicolaus & Company, has been helping people plan their financial future for over 100 years. Stifel Nicolaus has steered their clients successfully through the Great Depression, two world wars, and now is managing change in a global information-based economy. We are currently offering a free investment review at no cost or obligation. Stifel Nicolaus can provide you with an honest evaluation of where you're at now, where you want to be, and what it's going to take to get you there.
State news, local news, lots of people sharing views. Food, music, weather, sports, business,
TV,
stock reports, world news, people news, film, stage, book reviews, comics, coupons, cars, and trucks.
It doesn't take a lot of bucks.
Photos, features, classifieds, we print it all with lots of pride.
When you take us once a day, all of this will come your way. When you take us once a day, good things will come your way.
Need money fast? Purchasing a new or used car? Looking for a personal loan? Call 264-1188 to increase your buying power with a loan or a no annual fee, low 13.9% APR Visa credit card from Merchants Bank. Credit problems or no credit at all? Apply now for our Visa credit card. It's quick, easy, secure, and convenient. Call now on the automatic tele-loan phone, 264-1188 from Merchants Bank.
Young Willie, we had another tough one against the KC people. That's worth it. Don't kick that snow on me.
Oh, I'll dig it on your foot.
You did. Oh. You kicked it all over me for kind
of. Yeah. I love the snow.
I'm an old man. It's cold out, by the way, folks.
I think it's beautiful.
The weather outside is
frightful.
And we are so delightful. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
They're supposed to get another 4 or 5 inches.
No, we don't. No.
Hey, this is beautiful, isn't it, folks? Don't you love it when it starts snowing out here?
Not
the
really.
The signal the beginning of the cold
winter.
I love
winter weather, cold weather, but I could do without the snow.
Just like you could do without the Bears losing every week. We got to put up with it. But man,
well,
am I proud
what,
of those guys.
Craig's arm strength absolutely is atrocious.
Now, didn't we sit here 2 years ago and say the same thing about Steve Walsh?
No, right, and that's why. Ingram, as an example, a rookie, he had position on that. If he had gone up hard, he had his hands on it. Collins wanted the ball more than him.
And he did the old flex because he turned.
No, he grabbed the ball. Yeah, he grabbed for the hit. And then, boom, fumble. No, I'm talking about the lob in the end zone late.
Oh, he pulled his arms back on that.
Well, no, he was up here like this, and Collins went in and grabbed the ball and took it away from him.
Well, that's what I mean. He didn't have his arms extended.
That's what I mean. I read a book, by the way, The Choir Boys, and they had a guy they used to call him. That's what I mean, Dean. What do you mean, Dean? He used to say, what do you mean? What do you mean, Dean?
This available is, at your local library.
What do you mean, Dean? What do you mean, Dean? Anyway,
you know what I mean.
What else is going on?
Well, I think once again, we put our quarterback. Of course, it was a wing and a prayer. Anyway, but at that point, they should have taken the three, right? We threw away a field goal.
That was earlier.
It was with 4 minutes to go.
That was earlier.
So you take a field goal. Then at the end of the game, you just need to kick a field goal.
But earlier, if you remember, he was down there, and they got knocked backwards. We had a Big Cat Williams had a moving violation at 5 yards back, and then he got sacked.
I'm telling you.
And he should have thrown the ball away, by the way. He was outside the parameters where he could have thrown. He tucked the sack for 10 yards. He's a dog rabbit, folks. You're going to win this weekend.
I did
tell you that they would lose, but they did cover.
They're the hat.
Yep.
That brings your season average up to 66% here.
What a remarkable young man. By the way, what's going on out here with Andre Rison going up to the OPEC?
You know, they're scraping the bridge just like this.
You got it. Here's a guy.
There's Andre.
If one guy could handle him, maybe though, is Holmberg. If he gets it, this guy's the last chance. His last chance.
Holmberg is a good coach.
He's messed up five, but he's also a kind of a easy tempered guy.
Holmberg
knows the passing game and tells Rison. Rison's got a lot of talent. But he hasn't been same since that broad burned down his house.
That'll take the starch out of you.
When Atlanta was burning. When Atlanta was burning during the Civil War?
I remember that, Rhett.
Well, he hasn't been the same, but he is a
Frankly,
bad...
Frankly, Harry?
He's a
I don't give a damn.
Yes, right, Clark. Clark, the metal line.
Ah, oh, the great old classics.
Yes. I think Louis Holtz will be the next coach up at
I hope and pray that they hire Lou Holtz up in the land of the Viking.
Never happened.
Because that will assure
It might, but I don't think it ever happened because he knows nothing about the passing game. Never has and never will.
He wants to bring that option attack.
Well, yeah,
to the Vikings.
You try that option attack in a pro. You know, quarterbacks get killed now. They'd have to have about 9,000 quarterbacks.
Anyway, all you Irish fans, I'm sure they're going to get Barnett from Northwestern.
By the way, I'm telling you, no, I don't know about that. It's a real deal. He's got the job if he wants it. But you know, he's a different breed of cat, Barnett. And they've never been, Notre Dame's never been said no to.
In the locker room?
He's never been said no to. Notre Dame has never been said no to. Maybe a professional guy that they wanted, but.
I said no to him.
Yeah.
They turned me down for a scholarship.
Wide receiver,
they
right.
turned me down for a scholarship. I wrote a letter back saying.
Wide receiver.
If you're not giving me a scholarship, I'm not going there.
No, I know what it was. It was for the boxing. Right. It was for a boxing scholarship. Yeah, you saw how good he is on those boxing shows. A boxing scholarship. But
nobody says no to Notre Dame.
I told you Holtz would never stay. They would not keep Holtz, and he was forced out. He was forced out. I don't care disclaimers of what you say, because he was never going to break the deity's record. That's Newt
God's
Rock. Deity Newt Rock. His record.
And I thought didn't. God was the first coach there, yeah, no, but they didn't keep records back then.
I don't know. Sometimes you talk to some of these Notre Dame people.
He's undefeated versus the Christians.
The Knute Rockne is the guy.
Oh, yeah,
yes,
Knute.
Yes, Knute.
I saw the movie. That's another great classic with Ronald Reagan.
Hey, man, you're into classics. Look at me. I'm a classic.
I got nothing to do all day.
Look how old I am. I'm a classic. I'm getting old.
That's true.
I'm getting old. Back in the saddle again. Look at me shaking like this.
This is like a variety show this week.
Anyway, let's get on with this.
Hey, big thanks to Lion Metal, Harry.
Lion Metal all day, folks. Best company in the whole United States. Maybe the whole world. Yeah, it is.
Why not?
It is.
Whole world.
Great people. Great employment.
Quality product.
About 1,500 employees.
You bet.
All over. Not just in Aurora, but elsewhere. But
they have tentacles.
Tentacle.
All over these United States and close. Internationally.
That's close, pal. That's close. I did hear a cute joke. Real quick now. Real quick. Hey, hear me? These three doctors went up to St. Pete. She asked, St. Pete asked the first doctor, said, what do you do? And he said, I'm a gynecologist. He said, I take care of women, babies, and stuff like that. He says, come on in. He asked the second doctor, he said, what do you do? And he says, I'm a pediatrician. He said, I take care of the babies after they're born and help them up till about 12 years old. He said, come on in. Third doctor standing, what do you do, doc? He says, I'm an HMO doctor. He said, well, come on in. He said, by the way, you got 3 days to stay. You know, HMO, they say, you go in the hospital, you got 3 days, you got to get out. I'm an HMO doctor. You got 3 days. Well, let's get on the picks. Lions and Bears, I already told you, I thought that the Bears will cover. And
this is at Soldier Field, right, Harry?
3 points, and I think they'll win.
This is a 12 o'clock kickoff, right, Harry?
But I see they're coming back with
great chance to tailgate.
The left-hander, Mitchell. But
that's good.
Okay.
That's good because, you know, because with Majakowski.
You see that kick? It looked like it was going right through the middle. All of a sudden, it veered right. And that was indoors.
Brutal.
It looked like a knuckleball. All of a sudden, it went boom.
So Wayne is alive. I think we're going to take great pleasure in taking care of his regime.
Rajim Salah. I hate to say that.
That's our guy's brother.
What a piece of nothing.
No, come on. He's hurt, Harry.
Yeah, he's hurt. Run with that gate. I don't care if he runs for 200 yards this week. He's still not a football player in my mind.
He's a track.
But let's get about him with the Pack of the Rams. Where Andre Rison.
Here's a pack.
At the Rams.
What's the spread there, Harry?
9.5.
9.5 points. Could tempt a lot of people. I do think the Pack will handle the Rams.
You do?
Well, I don't think much of the Rams. Their record's just beneath the Bears.
Well, I'll take the Pack and give you the 9. But remember, they're coming off of a Monday night game.
Oh, I remember that game. They lost, didn't they? But it's 2 weeks in a row.
They don't have any wide receivers, pal.
Hold it. Newsflash.
I'll tell you what. I'll take the Rams in a 9.5 because I think.
Oh, you're going to take the Rams?
At 9.5, yeah. That's down at St. Louis. And the Pack coming off Monday night. They'll win, but I don't think they'll cover the spread. Okay, Denver at the Queens, we both were wrong last week. The Queens turned around and gave my old boy Mike quite a lesson in how to play football.
I told you anything can happen when those two dumb clubs get together.
Well, maybe the Lou Holtz syndrome, but Denny Green's a highly respected and highly liked football coach. And a very good football coach.
Well,
and Denver.
I hope he's got his resume ready.
Denver is playing at the Queens.
Ooh, and who's favored? Who's favored there?
Denver is favored by 5.5. This is a home dog.
Ooh, Central Division.
So I'm going to take the Queens this week.
Hey!
The Queens. I'm taking the Queens, the Bears, and the Rams. We're all on the right side of the board.
If I may interject.
Yes.
I think the Vikings, once again.
You don't like
take
the
Denver. You know, no, I don't like the Vikings. I don't like the Packers. And I don't like those Lions.
You like Tampa Bay?
Tampa, I like.
But I tell you what.
They seem to lose a lot.
There's a guy. No, there's a guy that's coming along. They won their last two ball games.
Tony Dungeon?
Yeah, Dungeon. And he is doing a good job. They don't give up many points. We only beat them by a few points.
They gave up 13 points 4 weeks in a row.
49ers at Washington. We got to move this show along because Harry's freezing.
Oh, you do?
Harry's freezing his butt off.
Oh, you got to pick up your ladies,
yes,
too.
And it's freezing my butt off.
What's the next game, Harry?
49ers at Washington.
Hey, now here, this is out for this NFC East division this week. Hey, everyone's playing each other.
I still don't think Washington's a good football team. I'm taking the 49ers.
You know that.
Philly and Arizona.
Hey, here's Arizona. Boy, they've been piling up the big numbers. Your man, Boomer Esiason, as you used to call him, the lefty.
Boomer Sooner. Okay, Philly at Arizona, 3.5. Now, who's getting the 3.5?
Well, the Eagles are favored.
Well, how can you got these things all on the right side?
See, whoever is underlying, Harry, that's the favorite.
Oh, gee, well, now, why didn't you say that? Okay, I got you now. Hello, Fanny. Okay, San Diego, KC.
It only took 14 weeks for Harry to figure out my calligraphy.
No, because I didn't look at the paper today. I've been so busy trying to take care of things.
Oh, that's right.
Yes. My buddy got home from the hospital, Bill Coffey, and go out and eat those clementines, Bill. They're good for you.
They sure are.
Those clementines, they're out. They just came out.
The oranges, right.
Those little oranges, they're like tangerines, but they're seedless.
Oh.
And they got a sweet, tart taste to them.
And you just peel, the peel comes off like a leather.
Kids can peel them. My little grandkids love them. They peel them and they come right off. Gabrielle liked them.
Oh, she loves oranges. No, not
I mean, clementines. She liked the clementine. Guys, you got me. Clementine.
You're for clementine.
Be careful. Clementine. Okay.
Hey, where were we?
Where were we? We were at San Diego at Kansas City.
Hey, here's another Kansas City.
Kansas City's 3-point favorite.
Gotta go with KC. Not really impressed with them after what I've seen.
I'll take KC and give San Diego a 3. They're not playing very good. They got beat by Tampa Bay last week at San Diego.
Doesn't look good. And who's the coach out there?
Bobby Ross.
That's right. He's been rumored for the Notre Dame job.
Oh, no.
Let's start one.
But I'll tell you what. I want to tell you something. If we can win, Wisconsin can win our next two ball games, we'll go to the Independence Bowl probably.
And who are we playing?
We got to play Illinois. We got a bunch of people going down there, and then we go to Hawaii. I'm going to babysit the kids. The grandkids.
Hawaii, that's a laydown, right?
No, you can go to Hawaii. They might look at too many hula hoop skirts. No, you don't know.
Oh, not this squad.
The way the Wisconsin team is, you don't know which one's going to show up. They play. They should win the next two ball games. Should.
They should.
Couldn't, wouldn't, and should. But we'll see who shows up.
And as far as Lou Holtz goes, Harry, the final word.
Final word, Lou Holtz will not go up to Wisconsin.
Lou Holtz to Wisconsin, folks. No, you heard it here.
No, he might be back at, by the way, Barry was offered a Minnesota job.
He was?
Yeah.
The Viking job?
No. The Minnesota.
Oh, the Gophers.
The guy called, he said, money would be no.
That's a lateral move.
And I wish you Wisconsin fans would hear that. Money would be no problem. They'd love to have Lou Holtz. They'd love to have Barry Alvarez up there. Put that in your Jesus, folks.
And who would you think would be the successor if Barnett doesn't take the bait?
Who? Bob Davies.
Bob Davies from the Kinks?
No, he's a defensive coordinator for Lou Holtz.
He's been mentioned.
I heard that he's got the Purdue job if he wants it, but Notre Dame's sitting in the wings. They're shuffling the deck and they keep the card.
And what do you hear from Illinois, Harry? Lou Tepper.
He said something about Snyder. But
Snyder the old janitor from the TV show?
Snyder changed the case. You talk about a program that was bad. Kansas State, he changed that around. But the only thing against me...